Hello.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Hello, Mingtek. Happy Saturday.
Happy Saturday, Randy. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. It's a Saturday. This is not our usual time and session. But today, we are very fortunate to have a very special company on board, RAMSSOL Group, which I think a lot of our investors, especially in Bursa, have tried subscribing for their IPO shares, and some were sad because they couldn't get, some were very happy because they got. So anybody got the share, type in IPO if you got the share. Or if you didn't get the share, type in, I don't know, I don't want to type in something like story, right? Type in wow if you didn't get the share, but you're impressed that wow, 100 something times oversubscribed, right?
Yeah.
So
I know a lot of my friends never get lah. I know.
Wait, some people bought it, you know, at a comment. This Karen got the IPO share, right?
Wow.
Good for you, right? So I'm very excited for this session because I would like to find out more about this company. Maybe some people, you know, you're thinking I couldn't get the IPO share, but maybe I want to buy the share on Tuesday itself. So whatever it is, tune in today. We managed to have the COO, CEO, CFO, the C-suite executives all here today. So it's going to be a very powerful session. Randy, what do you think?
Yeah, you know, even before this particular, when we were backstage, we were just chit-chatting with the management, you know. I think, I'm not sure, but I believe Clement would be one of the youngest CEO to actually get their company into an IPO. He's only a few years older than me, so it's very impressive. We'd definitely like to understand more about his company. So, Mingtek, shall we maybe, you know, do a round of introduction about ourselves first? Then we will introduce RAMSSOL.
Of course. So let me start with me. My name is Mingtek. I'm just a stock guru. No, this stock guru got a bad name like that, but I'm one of those stock guru. Hopefully, I'm one of the good ones. My job is to introduce stocks to total beginners, help people get started in investing, educate them on what's a risk, how to invest the right way, and how to grow your money from then on.
Okay, so it's my turn, and hi guys, my name is Rondi, and basically I don't own the platform Stockbit, but I help to grow Stockbit as a platform in Malaysia. Stockbit is a social networking platform for stock investors. It's an app where you can download. It's a place where you can discuss and you can learn and you can get information about the Malaysian stock market. So, you know, even with RAMSSOL, after this, if you would like to access their corporate presentations, and if you would like to continue discussing about the company, please tune in to Stockbit. Myself and Mingtek, we are there, and we can continue discussing about this company even post their listing date. Yeah.
Yep. So, Randy, let's cue the, you know, video presentation, should be?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah,
so let me, you know, video to share with you a small snippet on what RAMSSOL is all about before we start with the presentation, right? So this session will be about 20-30 minutes presentation to let you know what's the highlight of RAMSSOL about, then followed by a Q&A, right?
The management
life. Yep.
As a company that specializes in human capital management, RAMSSOL primarily serves as a solution provider in the human resource department through software and employee engagement systems. RAMSSOL started in Malaysia in 2010 and has since expanded to other countries, Singapore, Vietnam, Thailand, and Indonesia. In part of its growing influence, the incorporation of RAMSSOL Group Berhad has been made possible in 2019. Our milestone started back in 2010, and since then, RAMSSOL has been progressively achieving higher quality products and continuously upgrading their services to serve their clients better. This has been demonstrated by the numerous awards and accolades received on both national and international level.
My role as the Group CEO and Managing Director has been strengthened by having these amazing individuals alongside with me. I am accompanied by Ms. Li Yunlan, our Group COO, Mr. Brian Liu, our Group CIO, Ms. Saw Ming Si, our Group CFO. Together, we strive as the core of RAMSSOL Group Berhad, guided by the Board of Directors, led by our Group Chairman. We are confident to deliver the mandate given to us by our substantial shareholders, Tan Sri Dr. Lim Wee Chai and Mr. Alex Wong.
Oracle works as a resource planning software with tons of features that provide full access to the human resource experience. Oracle PeopleSoft offers the best human capital management solution for further improvement in business growth. Mobile apps, Fees, is a tool to help improve relationships among peers in a workplace. Lark offers convenience whereby messages, documents, schedules can all be in this one single place, which gives a great user experience for the client. Sage is effective for payroll needs management, whereby it is easy to navigate and hassle-free.
The fact that RAMSSOL Group is led by a dynamic team, they have a very good strategic planning, they always think ahead, they are very connected to the market, and also they listen to the customers, what needs to be done and stuff like that. What I like about their style of doing business is to help people to have a happier working environment. That is the most important thing. So I'm very happy to be a part of their group.
RAMSSOL has seen a steady increase in growth throughout the years. Revenue has seen an increase of 84% from 2017 to 2018, followed by a 23% increase from 2018 to 2019. To date, the revenue kept a steady growth with a 64% increase from 2019 to December 2020.
We are delighted to have seen our growth come to fruition. We look forward to greater success with our clients in years to come.
With clients of more than 70 companies throughout Asia Pacific, the company has been given the opportunity to work with some of the most prominent companies around, covering various types of sectors, proving to be a reliable ally in its field. The vast dynamic clientele is the proof and success stories of RAMSSOL Group Berhad. It's our responsibility and mission to serve our clients by advancing people through technology. Introducing its improved version of Feet's mobile app in their fleet of products and services. Engaging with people and advancing people through technology has always been our primary motivation to become the number one human resource provider as we strive to be.
And CEO of RAMSSOL Group Berhad. Let me start the IPO corporate presentation.
Orangnya. So guys, today the presentation is very special because it is done through a what we call augmented reality. Right, so let me play the video right now so that you can, you know, hear the presentation in a very smooth, very clear way. Right.
Hi everyone, I'm Clement Tan, Group Managing Director and CEO of RAMSSOL Group Berhad. Let me start the IPO corporate presentation. For today's presentation, I will be covering the offering summary, the company snapshot, prospects and plans. My colleague Ms. Li Mulan, our Chief Operating Officer, will be covering business overview and key investment highlight. And lastly, Ms. Saw Ming Si, our CFO, will be covering financial highlight. Let me go through our offering summary. We are going to list on the ACE market of Bursa Malaysia. Our issue price will be 45 cents per share with a market cap value at 100.4 million upon listing. The opening date of our IPO will be 22nd of June 2021. The closing date of our IPO application will be on 29th of June, and 13th July will be our date of listing. Next, I will cover the company snapshot. RAMSSOL is a local leading human capital management solutions and technology provider. We started our journey in the year of 2010 with the establishment of RAMS Malaysia, offering solutions in the field of human capital management and student management solutions. We have four key investment highlights featuring that Mulan will explain further in a later part. In terms of the company financial performance, we are proud to share that from 2017 to 2020, we have achieved a CAGR of 55% for revenue, 68% for gross profit, 305% for profit before tax, and 341% for PATAMI. This is our corporate structure where RAMSSOL Group Berhad hold 100% of RAM Malaysia's, which wholly own numerous entities across Southeast Asia under the name RAM Singapore, RAMS Vietnam. Besides, RAMS Malaysia does hold 48% of RAMS Thailand, approx 51% of FIS Malaysia, which hold 51% of FIS Indonesia, and lastly hold 99% of RAMS Indonesia. This is our shareholding structure post-IPO. Our promoters would hold roughly 57%, while there is approximately 8% held by pre-IPO investors and approximately 3% held by eligible directors, employees, and business associates. The remaining are from the public and selected investors. Our board will be chaired by Datuk Wix, who was formerly the CEO of Human Resource Development Fund, HRDF, and founded UMPR Consultancy and Training in the year of 2019, followed by me, who is responsible for the overall strategic directions, business development, and growth of the company. Ms. Lee Mulan is the non-independent executive director and COO of RAMSSOL Group Berhad. She is responsible for overseeing the operational function of the group and assisting in implementing operational strategies and policies. Our non-independent executive director and CIO, Mr. Liu Yuho, is responsible for overseeing all project deliverables, including managing resources and ensuring quality control procedures are in place to ensure quality and timely delivery of projects. Lastly, Mr. Goh Keng Tat and Mr. Sim Seng Nong as our independent non-executive directors. Our history can be traced back to 10 August 2010, when RAMS Malaysia was incorporated by myself and our COO, Ms. Lee Mulan, to undertake HCM and student management solution business. In year 2011, we marked our first project of HCM solution and commencements of our business in Singapore, and subsequently provide IT staff augmentation services. We have set up RAMS Vietnam in the year of 2013. In year 2014, RAMS Malaysia obtained Multimedia Super Corridor MSC status and secure first project in Malaysia to provide consulting and implementation of HCM solution and consulting of student management solution. We have successfully expanded our HCM solution business to Thailand in the year of 2015. At the same year, we have secured first consulting project in Vietnam from a BPO company. In year 2016, we are being nominated as the 25 most promising Oracle solution provider and top 10 Oracle cloud solution provider. In addition to that, we have also obtained ISO 9001:2008 certifications. We started the R&D of an employee engagement mobile application in the year of 2017. In the same year, we also secured the first HCM solution project directly from local recruitment and BPO company in Thailand. We are being nominated as top 25 HR technology solution provider in the year of 2018. In the same year, we have secured the first project in Indonesia
for the provision of consulting and implementation of HCM solution and sales of software licenses. In the year of 2019, RAMS Indonesia and FIS Indonesia were both incorporated to expand our business presence in Indonesia. In year 2020, RAMS Malaysia entered into a LUG partner network agreement with LUG Technology to become a reseller of LUG and reselling of Zoom in Asia Pacific region. Later in August 2020, we expanded our business into the provision of IT related training. In the same year, we are being nominated as Best SME HR Solution Provider. This year, we are going to list on the ACE market of Bursa Malaysia. Thank you, everyone. Now I would like to hand over the presentation to Ms. Mulan.
Thank you, Clement. Hi, everyone. My name is Mulan. I will continue the presentation by explaining our business operations. We provide three services and products, including provision of HCM and student management solutions, which are designed to manage employees and students. This aims to improve the efficiency of functions in organizations and educational institutions. Secondly, provision of IT staff augmentation services, which we will recruit and supply IT professionals to our customers on a fixed contractual period. Lastly, provision of HCM technology applications featuring FITS, LUG, and Zoom. Besides, RAMS Malaysia also provides IT-related training that focuses on office automation. Let me further explain on the HCM and student management solutions, where it comprises of four steps, including consulting, implementation, user training, and technical support and maintenance services. For consulting segment, we will study, understand the organization and campus requirements. After collecting all the required information, we will propose and design a HCM solution or student management solution. Next, we will provide software customization, configuration, and deployment. Once we deploy the HCM or student management solution, it will then go live and ready for use. We will then conduct user training to train the users on the functions of our HCM or student management solution. Lastly, technical support and maintenance. For a period of up to 1 year, we will provide starting from the solution going live. We also provide support and service to organizations and education institutes who do not engage us for consulting and implementation of HCM and student management solutions. We are involved in the sale of third-party HCM and student management software licenses. We do not sell HCM software licenses on a standalone basis if we are not involved in the consulting and implementation. However, we can purchase and resell software licenses to our existing customers for the purpose of license renewal on a yearly basis. On the right of the presentation, there is a list of HCM software that we are licensed by the respective software vendors to resell the software license, which are Oracle PeopleSoft HCM, Oracle PeopleSoft Campus Solution, Oracle Cloud HCM, Oracle Talent Acquisition, and Sage EasyPay. HCM solutions are IT solutions designed for HR management of organization. The cycle will start from hiring to resignation, comprising of five stages, which are recruitment and onboarding, daily HR management,
remuneration and statutory contribution, performance management, and lastly, exit or retirement. Student management solutions are IT solutions designed for student management of education institutes, which starts from enrollment to graduation. It comprises five stages, which are admission and registration, academic management, non-academic management, financial related management, and expulsion and graduation. We also involve in provision of IT augmentation services, where we recruit and supply IT professionals to our customer. The IT professionals are hired when needed under our payroll. We will perform pre-employment screening and interview to ensure that the IT talent matches the requirement. We provide basic soft skills training and onboarding briefing before the IT talent begins their employment. We charge our customer a monthly fee comprising the salary of the IT professional plus a certain percentage of markup. As you can see on the right-hand side, we have notable customers of Oracle, CapitaLand, and AIA. Under HCM technology applications, we have FITS, which is an employee engagement mobile application developed in-house and launched in 2019, both in Malaysia and in Indonesia. It promotes and modernizes communication between employees through inbuilt functions. FITS has integrated with Zoom, allowing users to access create Zoom meetings or webinars within FITS application. FITS helps to foster relationship between employees and enhance transparency across all levels of employees. We sell FITS to those customers on a monthly subscription based on number of users in the organization. The user dashboard that presents the stress, engagement, and happiness level of the employee to the management level. There are five core features of FITS, which are Connect, FITS, Weekly Quizzes, High Five, and Think. LARC is a single online collaboration platform for business that integrates multiple communication functions such as email, instant messenger, teleconferencing, and video conferencing, as well as other work-related functions. LARC helps to facilitate effective communication between employees. A key feature on LARC is the instant translation of messages or documents. LARC recognizes 100 languages and can translate them into four languages, which are English, Chinese, Thai, and Japanese. We offer LARC to our customer on a monthly subscription fee based on the type of account and number of users in the organization. As mentioned previously, the user interface for some of the key features of LARC includes instant messaging, teleconferencing, video conferencing, document sharing, calendar, and attendance management. In August 2020, we entered into an agreement with Megatech, an educational institution in Malaysia, to provide IT-related training to unemployed Malaysians under the Penjana Kerjaya program, introduced by the Government of Malaysia's Ministry of Human Resources. The IT-related training focuses on office automation, which involves digitalization of business operations using computer software. It aims to reskill and upskill Megatech's students in various aspects. the IT-related training provided to Megatech's students are conducted through LAC. In November 2020, our group began to resell or refer Zoom, which we purchase and resell the subscription of Zoom to our customers on an as-needed basis. Next, I will cover our key investment highlights. Firstly, we have a proven project track record in providing HCM and student management solutions to many notable local and foreign organizations, including large enterprises, MNCs, GLCs, conglomerates, and government agencies, as well as education institutes in Southeast Asia. Secondly, we have regional presence in Southeast Asia with offices across 5 countries, namely Malaysia, Singapore, Thailand, Indonesia, and Vietnam in Southeast Asia, each with their own local in-house consultants who understand local organization dynamics as well as local employment laws in their respective countries. Thirdly, we have over 10 years of experience in the HCM solution and technology business, and we have accumulated relevant HR knowledge to assist organizations in streamlining and enhancing their HR functions using HCM solutions. Last but not least, our key senior management team possesses in-depth industrial knowledge, technical know-how, and experience in HCM technology and solutions. Now, I would like to hand over the presentation to Ms. So Ming Sit.
Thank you, Milan. Hi, everyone. My name is Ms. So. Now, let me get into the financial highlights of the company. As at 31st December 2020, we have total assets of 19.8 million and total liabilities of 30 million and total equity of 6.8 million. Our net asset per share stood at 13.27 ringgit with a gearing ratio of 0.56 times and 2.61 times for our current ratio. Our revenue for the past 4 financial years has posted a CAGR of 55%. Our profit has been growing steadily over the last 4 years. In 2019, we ventured into the provision of HCM technology application by launching our in-house employee engagement mobile application, namely FITS. Our main revenue contributor is HCM and student management solutions, followed by HCM technology applications and IT staff augmentation services in financial year end 2020. In financial year end 2020, HCM technology application segment emerged as the second largest contributor to our group's revenue. It was contributed by the provision of consulting and implementation, as well as technical support and maintenance in the relation to LAC and provision of IT-related training to Megatech, a new customer secured in financial year end 2020. Thank you, everyone. Now I would like to hand over the floor to Mr. Clement Tan.
Thank you, Ms. So. At this part, I will touch on our prospect and plan. Based on the IPO price of 45 cents, we will raise total gross proceeds of approximately 25.1 million from the public issues. For the proceeds, approximately 10% will be used for business expansion into Philippines, 25.3% will be utilized for expansion of FITS and LAC in Southeast Asia, approximately 16% will be used for R&D expenditure, and all remaining will be used for working capital and listing expenses. Let me elaborate further on the rationale of business expansion into Philippines. As you can see, the size of the HCM solution industry in the countries involved, Malaysia, Singapore, Vietnam, Thailand, Indonesia, and Philippines, grew at a CAGR of 4.34%. We have captured a market share of 1.33% in the HCM solution industry in these countries involved. Digitalization of HR functions for greater operational and cross-departmental efficiency is expected to drive the demand for HCM solution. Hence, the expansion to the Philippines is expected to grow our business regionally and strengthen our position as a regional HCM solution and technology specialist in Southeast Asia. Looking at both employee engagement platform market and collaboration platform market, both have registered a double-digit CAGR of 14.7% and 17.1% respectively. There has been a surge in the demand for employee engagement platform and collaboration platforms since the outbreak of COVID-19. The expansion of Fizz and Luck is expected to contribute positively to our financial performance. In addition, it is also expected to enhance our brand exposure across Southeast Asia and attract more business opportunity to our group. We also intend to enhance the R&D activities primarily for the enhancement of fits and development of bolt-on modules for the HCM solution and plan to incorporate AI technology into fits. This AI technology will be able to provide impactful insight for employers to improve employee engagement, to retain valuable talents, and can offer predictive insight into employees' behavioral patterns. The enhancement of fits will attract more organizations to subscribe to FITS. Furthermore, we also plan to purchase software licenses of Oracle Corp, cloud-based HCM software for our internal R&D activities to develop bolt-on modules for cloud-based HCM solution. This will increase our flexibility in customizing HCM solutions, meeting customer demand, and attract more business opportunity to our group. The size of the IT staff augmentation industry in the countries that involve, measured in terms of sales revenue, grew at a CAGR of 2.55%. The demand for IT staff augmentation services will continue to be driven as organizations choose to leverage on the technical IT knowledge and IT recruitment expertise of IT staff augmentation service provider. Despite there is a slowdown due to the impact of COVID-19 pandemic, but we believe that such demand will revive once the impact of COVID-19 pandemic subsides and economy recovers. Hence, the expansion of our IT staff augmentation business will allow us to generate additional revenue, which in turn will improve our financial performance. We will also focus on increasing the sales of software licenses as part of the provision of HCM and student management solution, whereby we will purchase the HCM and student management software licenses from software vendor. As the sales of software license generate additional stream of profit, we intend to secure the sales of software licenses when we secure new project in the future. The ability to secure the sales of HCM software licenses along with our consulting and implementation services make us well positioned to be a one-stop solution provider for HCM and student management solution project in the future. In 2020, we harness the experience, knowledge, and relationship to expand the business into provision of IT-related training to Malaysians who intend to upskill their technical knowledge and skills, primarily in computer software and solutions. In addition to that, we intend to continue expanding this new business segment by closely observing the market needs. This is also an avenue to expand our subscriber base for Luck. With that, thank you everyone for your attention to our presentation.
Mingtek, you're muted, Mingtek.
Yeah. So that's a presentation. Can everybody type in, wow, if that's like a very powerful presentation, right? Got AR, zoom in, zoom out, all this. That's the first time I see the management really put a lot of effort into making, you know, presentation like that so that it's smooth and it's informative. And I can already see on the floor, there are a lot of very intelligent questions. Some of it will be asked by us already. Me and Rondi already have some questions that we ourselves want to ask, right? and some of it, you know, from the floor. Okay, right, Rondi, should we bring up the management?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so with us here, we actually have the Group MD and CEO, Mr. Clement Tan. Type in hello if, you know, if you want to have him on the floor. Type in hello, everyone.
Hello.
Mr. Clement, you are still muted. Let me unmute you.
Okay. Hello. Hi, Mentek.
Hi, Clement.
Hello.
How are you?
Hi, Mentek. We are doing great, right? And we are super excited to ask you more questions. Let us bring up also Ms. Lee and Ms. Saw, right, to support, right? And also to share with us the thoughts when we ask a question, right? But a lot of people are super excited with your listing, right? Some people who are ex-capital, all this, they are like exercising where the price will be. Anyway, right, let's start with a Q&A. Rondi, why don't you go ahead and ask a question?
But okay, before we start with the Q&A, Mentek, I heard that you're the top guru. So when you're going to teach me how to play stock, so I need to learn from you.
Actually, you should be teaching me, right? How you grow the company from very small into like so big, and it's not even like just the indicative price is already so big. I don't know whether the listing time, how much bigger it can become. I should be learning from you.
Let's see. I also anticipate for the time.
Wow, Joe Kote, handsome and beautiful. Wow. Okay, cool. Mondi, you go ahead.
Okay, you know, maybe just a small icebreaker, right, Clement? Now with EMCO and all that, are you going to the Bursa place there to hit the gong or not?
No, because I think from all the previous IPO, they also don't allow, so everything go by virtual. So the gong actually is in our office now.
Oh wow.
Right. I think it's more privileged and more exclusive, you know. Rather than going there now, I can play the gong in my office and very official time. Right.
Okay. Okay, thank you for that. Maybe I'll go ahead and ask the first very, very common question. There's a couple of people asking similar question, something like what Karina is asking here. But maybe let me just summarize it. Basically, a lot of people is wondering how sustainable is your company's business and its earnings, you know? Is the revenue and income, is it recurring or is it one-off? How does it work?
Yeah, I think that's a very nice question where everyone wants to know how sustainable is our business. I think trying to... Okay, let me try to understand or explain, like, you know, the business perspective here. Okay, so like what actually in showing in the presentations earlier, the video, you know, and in the prospectus, we actually divide our business into three segments, right? One is we sell license of Oracle, HCM, and also student management solutions, HR solutions, and then after that, we do implementation, and then after that, we collect support, right? So another segment is talking about IT staff augmentation. So when you talk about IT staff augmentation, so basically it's like, you know, like borrowing a people, you know, to our customers, and then we mark up our price and we get a recovery on the salary. And the third one pillar would be HCM technology applications, where we're talking about fixed luck and Zoom, right? Yeah, so let's do a role play to make it easier to understand. So assuming that you are actually not customer. Okay. Assuming that you are my customer, so what happened is, let's say today I'm selling you a HR solution. Okay, so what you need to do is that, okay, for example, let's say Stockpit have a HR department, right? So once actually Stockpit have a HR department, then you also realize is that, oh, Stockpit, you know, we have the Stockpit have a HR department, then the sorry, because a lot of disturbance on the noise.
Yeah, I also hear a little bit of disturbance.
Maybe Clement, if you are opening maybe your Facebook or your YouTube as well, just close them all. Just have your StreamYard on.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, I don't think so.
Now it's okay. Yeah. Now it's okay, Clement. Now it's okay.
Okay, it's now better?
Yeah. Yes, very, okay, very good now.
Yeah, so let me repeat. So assuming that Stockpit is our HR, so the sustainability wise is that today I implement a HR solution for stopping, right? Because you all want to go digitalization on HR. So basically we will tell you that stop it, your HR system today, you know, is very manual. So, and your current process, how you run your payroll, how you manage your leave application, how you manage your claim management, or how you manage your performance KPI to your employees or recruitment is very manual. Okay, because now the whole world is going for digitalization. So we will actually come up with a blueprint for you, and then we change the stop it HR from manual or to digitalization, right? Then you will be actually, we recommend you to buy using our recommended software, which is like Sage or Oracle's, right? Then after that, from there, when we actually sell you the software, then technically is that we will actually, of course, have the markup margins from the software. Okay, and then we will charge you a consultancy fees and the implementation fees depending on how big is stop it. Since stop it is so big, then perhaps the project could be talking about a 1 year or 2 years. So that is one time project basis cost. Then right after that, then there will be a recurring of the licenses, because you just bought the license and the markup. So every year is renewable. So everything that we actually, yeah, the license is renewable. Then after we implement, then you need that payment. I still need your expertise to give me consultancy and supporting the system, because I don't have anyone that's familiar with Oracle or Sage, right? So then they will be, okay, Clement, then why not you just sign a support and maintenance contract in the yearly retainer basis, okay? So same goes to student management solution, that exactly the same code that we actually providing to the universities, okay? So talking about the second segment, okay? Second segment is more sustainable, definitely, because the second segment, you're talking about IT stock implementation. So stop it today, you are actually growing very big, right? So you are growing as very, very huge, and you need to digitalize a lot of your internal system, software, applications, and so forth. But you are actually a stock guru, but you are not the IT guru, right? So as such, you tell me that, Clemens, I need your help. You know, I want to do this program, that program, you know, internally building up the system. So I need to ask your opinion or suggestions, you know, what kind of IT skill set that I need. So our job here is that to try to find a good IT skill set that fits into your project. So example, so now I found Rondi. Wow, Rondi, you are super good in programming of Java, for example. Okay, then, oh, Rondi, I'm paying you salary 20,000. So Rondi, and technically you are under my payroll, example. Okay, I'm paying you salary 20,000. So I outsource you to Maintech and to stop it. And then Maintech say, okay, I will pay you 25,000 for Rondi. So our margin would be the 5,000, right? A sample. Okay. Is it too low for you, Rondi, 20,000 as an example? I'm too sorry about that. I think 10,000 as your payroll anyway.
I'll take whatever that I have.
Correct. So typically, then Maintech will be like, okay, I need Rondi for 1 year, because I think then, you know, and it's a monthly recurring where we actually paying you salary, and Maintech will pay me 25,000 and you pay me, pay you 20,000, right? So speaking of which, and the last segment is more sustainable, because fits our homegrown apps, talking about employee engagement. LARC is a social collaboration platform. Zoom, by all means, everyone will know what is Zoom, right? So basically, Zoom, Fizz, and LARC is a recurring, where in the sense that we are selling the licenses subscription basis. Okay, so we have a high margins on that. Eventually, everyone will be renewal every year. And when we charge Fizz, LARC, and also Zoom, we are charging by enterprise model, which is selling by employee perpetual. Okay, so example, let's say Fizz, we are selling at let's say 10 ringgits per employee per companies. Okay, so imagine if the companies like Stockpit, you have 1,000 people, assuming I think you have more than that, right?
No, we don't.
So maybe, yeah, once you have 1,000 people, or even now you don't have 1,000 people, you know, to make you all easier to understand, just subscribe to Fizz, LARC, and Zoom with us after this call. Okay, then 1,000 Yeah, so 1,000 people, then 10 ringgits, 10,000, then 1 year, 120,000. So every month you are paying us 10,000. Right. Similarly to Zoom. Yeah. So in terms of sustainability wise, that is explaining based on my business models explanations. So first pillars, second pillars, and third pillars, you know, is a sustainable models, because we have the support, we have subscriptions on the licenses. Okay. And also, as you can see that, most importantly, as an LPD, so LPD referring to the prospectus LPD, which is somewhere around May of this year, right? Mm. So last year, we achieved 25 million revenue. So as of May, we already achieved 19 million, our order book already stood at 19 million.
Mm.
As of May, yeah, that is not even counted yet for the rest of the months from May to, yeah.
Okay. Great. Yep. Awesome. Just a follow-up question on that, right, Clement? There is one question here from Lukman, and he's actually wondering, can you share with the audience how many clients does RAMSSOL have and how much is roughly a ticket size on this HCM solution? And in terms of the yearly contract, you know, do people actually sign up immediately for, say, a 2 years contract and so on?
Okay. How many clients does RAMSSOL have? Okay, so if you look at our corporate video, you can see that you go to our website. We have mostly our client is MNC GLCs, right? Yeah. So when we actually introduce a HCM technology application, which is like Plug, Fit, Zoom, so it's actually covering more than a lot of SME also. Okay, because previously, like IT supplementation or HCM solutions or student management solution, many our customer is like those like CapitaLand, Bank of Ayutthaya, you know, CIMBs, and so forth and so forth. All these banking and also big companies, right? Mm. So when we talk about HCM technology applications, you know, then IT someone then is like considered a lot of SME. So talking about how many customers that we have, yes, we have a lot of customers. Okay, so for first segments, HCM and student management solutions, customers is all MNCs. IT staff augmentation is also many MNCs like AIA, Oracle, and CapitaLand, you know, these kind of customers. Then the third pillars, Fits, Plug, and Zoom is like any of the customers, regardless whether it's MNC, GLC, or SME. Yeah.
Mm.
Okay. Then to answer your second question, what is the contract normally? Is it the contract size or
the ticket size? Yeah,
the ticket size. Okay, so technically, basically, it's like first pillar when we actually implement human capital management and student management solutions. The contract is very depending on how many modules they actually buy. Because, like for example, top pick today, I want to buy a recruitment system first, performance management system, payroll system. Okay, the leave system maybe no need first, later first. Okay, so it's typically depending on what module they buy first, okay? And then, of course, how many countries we need to help the customer to roll out. For example, some of our customers is banking. They are present in Malaysia, not only Malaysia, Singapore, Philippines, Indonesia, Thailand. Then, you know, every country has to be Malaysia. Let's say they are headquarters. Then we have to be implement Malaysia, then implement the rest of the country. And also depending on how many employees they have, because we need to perform a lot of data migrations. So typically, the contracts, durations should be talking about 1 year to even up to 3 years, okay, on the project basis. Then support wise, then like CapitaLand, you know, they've been engaged us for support since day one when we happen to implement, when we establish our company. Till date, they also engaging our support, not only CapitaLand but a lot of customers that have the same. Okay, so for the support renewal will be yearly or 2 years, every 2 years.
Okay. Clement, I think there is a follow-up question on Oracle. I think, you know, some people are quite confused, perhaps. So Nick here is asking, just curious, HCM is developed by Oracle. How come they are also your customer?
Okay. Yeah. That's a good question. But in fact, actually, it's like this. Okay. So some of the customers is like big MNC, for example. I don't name the name, just like I said, there's a bank in Malaysia. Okay, so they like, okay, I want Oracle to be my human capital management solutions.
Yes.
Okay, so what happened is that, oh, but I don't want to have vendors and also the software, you know, the vendors of the consultancy and the software provider different. So they say, who knows Oracle better than Oracle? This is the terms that, you know, the customer always asks. So, you know, so they say, okay, I buy Oracle, but I want Oracle to prime the project. Okay, but I like them to implement. So, but legality wise or the compliance wise, they want a single vendor, then no choice, then Oracle will be stuck the whole contract to me.
Okay.
Yeah, correct. And because also some of the customers, big MNC, they want a very huge listed companies and also branding wise, recognized companies to help them to implement. Okay.
Mm.
Yeah. So that's also one of the reasons why we are IPO today. So we wanted to practice transparency. So we want to let the company know that we are growing big, we are credible, and we are credible. So, you know, this kind of confidence and reliability that we want to portray to our customers.
Thank you. I think there was actually a question which is asking why you're going IPO, but you have addressed it. So thanks for that. Maybe I'll just ask one last question before I pass it on to Ming Teck. This question I'm going to bring up is from Michael. Michael, seems like he has been reading your prospectus. He wants to ask, you know, just now in terms of your presentation, you also mentioned Megatech as a new client. So Megatech contributes about 35% of the revenue and your relationship with them is only about 1 year. Is this something that investors should be worried about?
What do you think?
Perhaps you can answer this one.
No worries. Nothing to worry because, you know, like you see HCM technology application, the lab, okay? Megatech is referring to the lab. So what happened is that when we actually, prior to COVID, we already have lab on board in RAMS. Okay, so lab is basically a social collaboration platform like this, like Zoom, where they do the video conferencing. And then the best part of lab is that they have a mini apps where we can configure like timetabling for students, you know, student assessment, e-certification, and so forth and so forth. So with this lab, video conferencing, and also, you know, we allow Megatech to use this tool during this COVID time and perform a hybrid classroom. Okay, and eventually after they use it and they are so happy that this lab can not only serve as a video conferencing, but at the same time, it also serves like timetabling, scheduling, student assessment, attendance, and so forth and so forth. We have more than 9 to 10 features that is suitable for the educational industries. Okay, that's where Megatech chose us. And in fact, actually, it's not only helping them, but in terms of performing the hybrid solution and continuing their business as usual, but it's also helping them to save the cost in terms of the facilities because it's a new norm. So we believe this is the future. And Megatech gives a very, very good feedback and testimonial and sharing to all the Megatech peers or counterpart, okay, that is also a training providers or the universities. Okay, then, and in fact, actually this year, we also have new customers in Malaysia that actually using this lab, and you generate more revenue. So, so we plan to closely observe the market needs and demand, you know, for specific training program from time to time, and to actively also we seek collaboration with third parties also for new business opportunities. Yeah. So don't worry about the contract end because, as usual, our business is every year renewable. Right.
Yeah. And the market is big, lah, you know, there is a huge addressable market there. Yeah.
Correct.
Okay, Ming Teck, over to you.
Okay, my question is, how has this pandemic impacted your business? Did it help your business or did it harm it, especially moving forward? Mm. Actually, the longer the lockdown is, the more worried it is because maybe companies are feeling the pain and may cut down on their budget, all this. So how do you see it moving forward? And if this pandemic is good for you, then what happens after the pandemic? How do you sustain the momentum?
Okay, so let me put it this way. One thing, speak with the matter of fact, right? So matter of fact, 2019 versus 2020 revenue growth from 50 million to 25 million, right? So last year, the pandemic COVID already impacted us on the lockdown. So despite the lockdown, but we still have a high spike of the revenue and the profit, okay? Because of, you know, myself and my mentor, Ms. Lee Mulan, our group COO. So we foresee or, you know, not to say foresee, but we see that this is even no pandemic, that this is the trends of the futures. Because for example, like, you know, having Zoom is no longer a wants, it's a needs, right? It's become an essentials. And tell me who doesn't know what is Zoom and how to use Zoom for now, right? So employee engagement mobile apps is like, it's a new trend because, you know, everyone working from home, how the employer very worried, the boss very worried to, you know, how to boost up the morality of the people. Okay, so speaking of which, whether this COVID impacting me or not, and if there's no more COVID, of course, we are more than happy, correct? So so from the fact is we drove the revenue spike, okay? So second explanation, whether this COVID impact my business or not. So let me give you a scenario that will be more easier to understand. For example, Stockpit being our customers during COVID. Okay, so you all buy our HR system. Then the problem is that after you all purchase this HR system, you go for digitalized because all is manual used to. And then after that, you all go to digitalize and engage us to go digitalize. And what happened if there's no COVID? Okay, you all will still having the HR system because you all been cannot be going back from digitalized to manual back. Right, and then eventually you will need my support in terms of the application. So second things, IT staff augmentations, which is our specializing in finding the IT skill set of people. Okay, happy or not, during this pandemic, a lot of people want to go digitalization internally for their apps, right? Just like I mentioned earlier. So eventually they still continuously knowing that the whole world is changing to digitalize. That's why they need to find more people digitalized. So whether COVID or no COVID, the whole world or the company is also looking forward to digitalize. Okay. And the third one, Fit, Zoom, and also Lab. Okay. Imagine Stockpit has subscribed to Fit, Lab, and Zoom. Okay. And without pandemics, I think you all been used to it and also thinking that, you know, and this remotely working from home is so efficient. I don't think you all will unsubscribe Zoom by all means. Yeah. So in nutshells, I don't see that you will actually impact, but in fact, actually with all the application and the services that we carry, you will bring more benefit to the organization.
Yeah. I think I just would like to add on to that, you know, Clement, and Ming Teck, yeah, before you ask the next question, because, you know, even in Stockbit as a startup company from Indonesia, I'm actually really seeing a shift into how HR plays a role, right? I think just a few days ago, our HR team actually organized such event, which is basically saying like the secret of building your life's purpose in Zoom. And then just the other time also, we actually organized some sort of like a chess tournament between all our developers and all our analysts and whatnot. So I think, yeah, it's true that, you know, I am also personally seeing a big shift in terms of the digitalization of HR. HR is just no longer your typical payroll and employing and all that. It's also about employees' welfare and all this sort of thing. So I believe that, you know, your company is in a good space, I would say, Clement.
Thank you.
Just thought of adding up on your point.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, Ming Teck, sorry. Ming Teck, you're muted.
Okay, understand. Good to know, Rondi. My company is very small, so I don't even get the opportunity to learn all this HR stuff. I'm the employee.
At least you still can subscribe to the Zoom from us.
Yeah, so that's why. Which brings me to the next question. Can you explain like how is your collaboration with Zoom, right? Are you reselling the Zoom software? And if yes, like why would they let you get at a cheaper price?
Okay. I think, you know, I really love to answer these questions. And then, you know, the best person to answer this question is my mentor, Miss Lee. You know, she is like having more passion to answer these questions, why we want to collaborate with Zoom. Milan, you want to answer?
Yeah, okay. Why? Why do we collaborate with Zoom? Actually, we have two levels of collaboration with Zoom. First is, of course, we can resell, we can refer. All right. So Zoom, of course, you can buy Zoom from their website, right? But if you are asking for more than 10 licenses, okay, then not only in terms of pricing, but in terms of how you configure it, how you do your breakout rooms or how you do your lounge is actually very important, how you configure it. Okay, so that's why we are helping organizations to set those particular features out. Okay, so we resell Zoom for larger accounts where people want thousands of accounts, then we refer it back to Zoom. They will have the better capability of managing those accounts. Now, on the second point, we are an ISV partner. So what is an ISV partner? ISV is an independent software vendor. So we are an independent software vendor for Zoom. Okay, now what does that mean? Means that whoever have a system that wants to directly connect with Zoom, okay, we can build the connector in order for Zoom to directly connect with whatever software they have. But mainly because we are a HR system provider, we connect it to their HR system. Okay, example, our feeds is directly connected with Zoom. So you do not need to open Zoom, you do not need to go to Zoom portal to create your meetings and whatever. It is directly inside our product. Okay, so this is two different ways. So we can resell, we can refer, and of course we can build connectors directly to Zoom. So that is mainly our collaboration with them.
Thank you for the sharing. Not easy. I have tried to integrate my website with Zoom as well. And that's like already the easy version, Puna. There's like a lot of coding thing, which I don't know how to do it. Which is why you guys also actually have the IT department and all this, right? So my follow-up question will be, how are you different to your competitors, right? Like, let's say if the big ERP, maybe Oracle or SAP want to expand into your niche and territory, how do you make sure your position is not threatened? And as of now, do you see yourself as one of the market leader in, you know, this region?
Okay. So how am I different? Okay. So first of all, I think, you know, I'm not in a position to comment on other industry players. So as stated in our prospectus, you know, one thing is we strongly believe in our competitive strengths. Okay. For example, like, you know, HCM solution vendors such as Oracle, SAP, Workday, and the implementation consulting firm, which is one of our competitors, like KPMG, Deloitte, Accenture, you know, those are actually a large MNC. So through our actually specializations in the local workforce requirements and lean and nimble startup, so we believe that it's actually differentiate us to compete with them at the local level. So in terms of profit margin, you can see that our profit margin is superly is very decent and very reasonable. Okay, while we cannot comment on our competitors, we believe that our cost competitiveness is the reason for our high margin. So in terms of growth, we are still a young company with just 10 years plus history. I don't consider myself as a market leader because I see that there are tremendous growth for our company to, you know, if you look at prospectus and also our market research, they are, you know, the percentage of RAMSSOL Group capturing in the market is talking about very, 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 very little percentage, okay? Because there are still a lot of companies who haven't gone digital inclusion. Okay, then a lot of startup companies, SME companies is going big and big, where they need to go for more sophisticated HR systems or using, you know, having more, they know how to treasure their employees on having fixed application to engage their people, you know, having luck or, you know, having more Zoom account because the employee size keep on growing. Okay, so in terms of growth, you know, market share in HR tech industry is rapidly growing. So we see a lot of potential for us to grow exponentially going forward. You know, especially, you know, our MNC customers is being very stable customers. You know, the more they grow the company, the more employees they have, which means the more licensing that we can sell in a way. Okay, the more license we can sell, the more revenue and the more profit that we can get. Okay, yeah.
Okay. One interesting question, because I saw in your video state that Tan Sri Lim Wee Chai is actually one of your substantial shareholders. Actually, in the comment also, some people were asking.
Yeah.
So just wondering if Top Glove is also one of your clients. Then if it's not, then maybe you can also share with us, like, you know, how's the process like to get Tan Sri to become one of your shareholder? What caught him to invest in RAMSSOL?
Actually, yeah, the is a quite nice questions also. Okay, so Tan Sri, you know, I know him is when during the time we, you know, we are serving all the big MNC customers. So being top left is a very big company. Right, no doubt on that. So we actually present the we do some presentation on them on the fits, you know, and Tan Sri is actually quite impressed on the fits. And you know, in Tan Sri, you know, in the meetings asking me, hey, this young guy, you know, he said, this young guy, well, wow, you are so young and then you are running this IT company and it's makes so profitable. And you know, yet my IT team, you know, have to learn something from there, you know, something like that. So that's where, you know, he actually endorsed our fees. So technically TopGlove is not our customer. We provide them the free trials to TopGlove as a to as a transitory to a few skill implementation. So we need to be mindful that, you know, TopGlove is a large organization with a lot of employees. The implementation need a really careful planning. Having said that, actually we actually appreciate Tan Sri Lin, you know, investment in us, which brought us to, I think, 1 year back. Yeah, that brought us to even before COVID. Yeah, Tan Sri invested even before COVID in our companies. So that brought us to where we are today. And we do not rule out a further strategic investment from Tan Sri if the opportunity arise, definitely. So further, also all the pre-IPO investors, including Tan Sri, have also, you know, they've been so confident on us and they have voluntarily undertaken not to sell their share for a period of 1 year after listing. Okay, I think that is very important, which demonstrates the investor confidence in our, what they call, longer term performance. Right.
Wow. So it's the fit software, am I right, that really attract Tan Sri's attention?
Mm-hmm. Right. Because yeah, go ahead. Sorry.
Yeah, so actually, like, what's your target for this fit in terms of the next 4 years, 5 years? Like, how big do you want to grow it to? What's your target user? And then what's the profit margin like? And also, in the future, would this become like the main contributor? Would it be like RAMSSOL become like an app company, like Fit is RAMSSOL? Then the other is like very small segment.
Correct. Actually, now you see that everything, a lot of RAMSSOL group, we have multiple services, multiple product we carry, right? So, and you can see that, you know, everything, we still have a mascot of this. This is a, have a mascot. If you see our, just now the video, there's a mascot just like this shirt also, you know? So this shirt is the mascot and it represents me, basically. So myself and actually my mentors, founders, Miss Lee, why we come up with FIS. So FIS is like, we know it's a futures. Okay, by all means, it's really a futures. So how I see these apps is like, I think it's my futures also. It's our RAMSSOL futures. Okay, what we are looking at is we're looking at a whole Malaysia workforce, even 1% or 5% of whole Malaysia workforce that using FIS, and the revenue can go up to over 100 over millions or even to a billions. Okay. We quite confident as like we actually looking forward the next 4 or 5 years. We hope that we will increasing capturing the market share of the workforce in Malaysia and also other countries like Indonesia, which already have FIS. And we are further expanding FIS into like all the countries that we present, like Singapore, Thailand, you know, Vietnam, or even the next Philippines as well. Okay. So imagine if all the countries just 10% workforce or 20% of the workforce is using FIS as employee engagement apps in their organization. So now, then it would eventually, these apps would be coming to be a next super big unicorn, which I hope so. Yeah.
I also hope so, right? So, Rondi, over to you.
I think we all hope so, you know, because yeah. In Malaysia, we don't really have like a unicorn status yet, right? So yeah, maybe RAMSSOL can be the one. US dollar unicorn.
That's my vision. It's one of the unicorn or Kasam, isn't it? But Kasam, definitely looking for more, right? Yeah. So Rondi, over to you.
Okay, maybe, you know, we will move into finance related question. Maybe Miso, this could be an area. I think you touched on the margin in terms of gross profit margin and PATAMI margin. But what are the sort of like strategies to improve this margin going forward?
Okay, I think Miso, maybe you want to answer this? Finance related questions?
Okay. Hi, I'm Miso here. Our GP margin and PATAMI margin for financial year end 2020 stood at 61% and 29%. So we'll continue to look for opportunity by like consolidating and expanding our business and strengthen our existing competitive advantage so that we can excel in our business. And hopefully, like Clement said, we at least can 10 or 20% of Malaysia workforce, then I think our business will grow very fast.
Okay. So another question is, a few days ago, you guys released your quarter one financial result, right? I think what I know is a lot of people are also wondering, right? And I do receive quite a common question. What we saw then is basically your profit after tax is about close to RM1 million. As Malaysian investors, they straight away do an annualization of that, right? So one multiplied by four becomes 4 million. Then they're like, hey, why 4 million is lower than your full year 2020? So yeah. I suppose because it's a newly listed company, so we are not able to compare it quarter to quarter and year on year and all this sort of thing. Yeah. Maybe you can let us know on that. And is there actually like a seasonality factor in your profitability? And what constitute to the, I don't know whether you consider it as low, but what constitute to be a RM1 million profit?
Okay.
On quarter one.
So, I think this one Meng Teh definitely will know because he is a stock guru. Normally, a stock guru will definitely go and evaluate and also to see our prospectus, whether, how's our performance for the past, how we our viewing accounting, in our companies. Okay, if you look at our prospectus, sorry, I think there's some disturbance. Can you hear me? Hello?
Ken Clement, a lot better now. Okay, now Clement is frozen. Clement, are you there? Meng Teh, can you hear?
Yes, I'm here. I'm just checking whether the disturbance is coming from my mic. That's why I'm turning off.
No, I think it's coming from Clement's side.
Is it? Okay. Yeah. I think Clement is now, disconnected. He's coming back in. So please have some patience. The connection a bit, having some trouble. It's a Saturday, like everybody watching movie, streaming Netflix at home.
They're all in Zoom having some human resources training.
Yeah. So guys, one very important distinction that you need to understand with RAMSSOL is definitely, because initially what I thought is like a HR company, but after hearing more, it's more like a software company. Initially, there is some segment that is sort of like reselling software and consultation, but now they themselves have their own software. Is that right to say that, Miss Lee? Correct, right?
Actually started as an IT company. It's just that we specialize in human resources. And throughout the years, we have done so many human resource implementation. Yeah. Good thing that we are a HR company. Yeah.
Clement is back. Yeah, sorry, I don't know why, they don't want me to answer these questions, I have no idea why, But anyway, yeah, speaking of which, there are not seasonality factors, on these things. If you look at our prospectus, normally our Q3 and Q4 revenue and profit will be up more than the Q1 and Q2 because, human capital management solutions, example, you know, when we implement a project for our customers, a lot of times the milestone will be at the back when we complete the project at the end of the year, because a lot of companies would like to go live on the 1st of January, you know, of next year, so that all the tax calculations, you know, SOC calculation or EPF calculation, we doesn't need to do the back date and so forth. There will be more clear cut. That's why a lot of invoicing, it will be at the Q3 or Q4. Okay, and of course, based on the best part is that based on the unbilled order book of 19.4 million, 16.2 million is expected to be billed in 2021. So if you add up our revenue of 5 million for Q1, the total is already 21.2 million. This is before taking into the account on the project that we have or we will secure after the LPD, which is after the May this year. So last year, 25 million revenues. This year, as of, you know, looking at the order book plus the 5 million revenue for the Q1, we already achieved 21.2 as at LPD May, right? And if you actually comparing the result of this Q1 and the last year Q1, is basically our revenue is increased. Okay, our revenue is increased. And our profit is actually about the same, because we have incurred more expenses due to, you know, IPO. IPO, a lot of expenses have to spend, right? So the total unbilled amount for human capital management, HCM, and student management solution now is about 9 million approximately. So once there are some ease of the lockdown actually in the respective countries, actually our countries like Malaysia, Thailand, Indonesia, Vietnam, or, you know, a lot of lockdowns. So our project delivery schedule, you know, could be accelerated with more physical engagement with our customer representative. Right.
Okay, thanks, Clement. Another financial question that we get is, from what we can see in your quarterly report again, we can see that the latest receivables is about 12 million ringgit, which is about 50% of your full year 2020 revenue. Can we know that, you know, as of the past month, as of June 2021, what has been the status of these receivables? And what are your typical sort of like receivable turnover days? Is this sort of like high receivable something that is associated to your company and something that we should be worried about actually?
Don't need to worry, because my CFO is very good on that. I have a CFO, I have a very good financial controller, and yet, you know, the best part is that mostly our customer is MNCs, right? So MNCs companies don't need to worry, because MNC company, they also have their own reputations, you know, and there will be a sign off for every single receivable. So there's nothing to worry on that. So speaking of which, talking about SME companies, okay? Like example, like, you know, when those people subscribe to our lab and Zoom and Fizz, you need to pay, only you can subscribe, right? So you need to pay for your Zoom subscription, only we will actually assign the apps or the platform to you. So that is not something that we need to worry about. Yeah. So of course, when we try to implement our human capital management or student management solution to our customers, our credit terms to customers are assessed and also like approved on a case-to-case basis. So taking into consideration like various factors such as like how good is our relationship with our customers, customers' payment histories, credit worthiness, you know, volumes, transactions-wise, financial backgrounds, market reputations, you know, and so forth. But ultimately, those customers that actually buy our HR system, they already know that this is they already prepared for the budgets already,
Okay, thank you. Ming Teck, over to you.
Sure. But you know, Miso, anytime you will wanna, you know, jump in to clarify, let's say if you're asking about finance related question, you are welcome to right.
Because just now we mentioned about seasonal. I just want to emphasize that we are not in seasonal, I mean billing, because the milestone of the project not achieved yet. That's why the billing is not, we are not going to bill it monthly. We only will bill it upon we achieve the milestone. Yeah, so that is not on seasonal issue.
Yep. Okay, thank you.
All right.
I pity Miso because Miso just vaccinated yesterday.
Oh, I see. Good for you, Miso.
Yeah, but still okay now. Very excited about this event.
Very excited to hit the gong.
What is the PE ratio based on the issue price?
PE ratio, okay, our share is 45 cents, our PE ratio around 13.24. Yeah.
How much do you expect to grow moving forward? Let's say the company revenue. Oh, cannot guide, right? This kind of thing. So, not supposed to ask this question. Please don't answer. Yeah. What is the dividend policy of the company? Do you have any?
Dividend, before listing, yes, we do pay dividend. After listing also, we are, of course, we would love to pay dividends, okay? But anyway, the exact payment amount of all the dividend, is distributed to our shareholder will be at the board decisions. Yeah.
Okay, got it. In your video, as well as during some of your sharing, you mentioned that Philippines is one of the countries that you want to go into, and also the IPO proceed is like you want to expand into other countries, specifically Philippines. So can you share with us like why Philippines, like what is the thing that attract you so much with Philippines? What's your game plan? So number one, what is so attractive? Number two, what's a game plan, right? What are you going to do to, enter into the market, and when do you expect that to happen?
Okay, why Philippines? Because of MCO, I don't have a mate now. I need to fly to Philippines and find my mate back first. No, just kidding. Anyway, yeah. So why Philippines? Because I think, like I mentioned earlier, we roll out a big MNC, GLC companies that have a presence in Philippines, and our customers, we cannot disappoint our customers in the sense that, customers say, Clement, I give you this project, help me to implement for Malaysia, Singapore, Thailand, Indonesia, and maybe Vietnam. But hey, what you get in Philippines, then how? So by all means, no choice, because we have a lot of customers now, and they also have Philippines presence, you have to be in Philippines at the same time. Okay, so what is the next target and see like how we actually move to Philippines? Because last 2 years we already started establish Indonesia. Okay, the same concept how we actually moved to Philippines, okay, where we already established the discussions with our principals of all the products that we're carrying, and also of course never forget our homegrown product fit to bring over to Philippines. Yeah. So when we will go, I think due to the pandemic. So of course myself or all the potential directors, executive directors, not able to fly over to set up an office there, signing all the resolutions and so forth. Yes, we do. We actually have a co-working space and plan to set up an office in Manila within 12 months upon meeting. But it's also very subjective depending on whether we're allowed to fly or not. So in fact, our team is discussing with Oracle Philippines to explore more business opportunities already, or even other products that I mentioned earlier.
Okay, that's all from me. Randy, any final questions before we conclude the sharing? It's been 1.5 hours. Thank you everyone for staying all the way. Very interesting sharing.
Yeah, I think maybe just one last question from myself. Because I personally like to invest in tech and startup companies as well, right? And I think, after listening and tuning into RAMSSOL, I think there are, at first, honestly speaking, when I looked into the company, I thought it's just a normal SI company. But I think, I believe that RAMSSOL is more than that. So just now Clement mentioned that, your big goal is to become a unicorn as well, right? So I suppose, where do you see, as a last question is, where do you see RAMSSOL going to be in say the next 10 years or 20 years and so on and so forth, Clement? Okay. That will be the final question. Yeah.
So as the group MD and as the founders and as the CEO of RAMSSOL Group, you know, I've been working tirelessly day and night to ensure that group perform well and move into the right direction, you know, to create a long-term value. Okay. So the development and growth of RAMSSOL Group today proves us well. So RAMSSOL Group, you know, IPO is one of the most remarkable achievements in my life journey. And our IPO have oversubscribed by 102 times. So of course we are truly enjoy and grateful for all these encouraging responses, you know, responses and strong support received from the investor. So just like the Q1 result that actually we just released, okay. So the business of the group is actually one very significant is we never expected by any significant seasonal or cyclical factors, right? So especially if you look at based on our unbilled order book of 19.4 million, you know, this 16.2 million is also expected to be built in the year of 2021, you know, and so forth. So the point is, with the homegrown human capital management solution, the technology provider, you know, what I want is we want to continuously working to equip ourselves to exist Malaysia, remain more competitive. You know, I always like to help people. I wish to, you know, after I graduate as an IT, I also wish my children to be growth in the IT industry, to be very honest, right? So, and I hope all Malaysia remain competitive with other countries within the industry. We hope like, you know, like you say, Malaysia lack of some unicorns. I also one of them. Okay. And every Malaysian will take part in the advancement of our IT industry. It's always my vision, you know, to bring Malaysian IT industry to the next level, become the industry leader in the future. Being RAMS is a industry status company, you know, in Malaysia. Okay. Of course, with the strong establishment and proven track record, you know, we are optimistic about our group prospects. Leveraging on our competitive strengths. That's my belief. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, great.
Very interesting sharing from Mr. Clement and Ms. Lee and Ms. So. I think we had a very, very good interview today. I managed to learn much more about RAMSSOL than we know on the surface, right? So, Rondi, any final remarks? If not, then we pass to Mr. Clement, right? What's the one thing that he wants us to remember about RAMSSOL?
I just firstly want to say congratulations, Clement, you know, Mr. and Ms. Lee. I think, you know, going to bring your company to become a listed company is a dream for a lot of entrepreneurs, and you guys are there. So firstly, congratulations on that. We will definitely keep following up on your developments going forward. The investment community will do that as well. I think that's all for now. Thank you.
Yeah. But actually before I end, you know, first and foremost, you know, I want to extend my gratitude to Venkat and Rondi. Thank you for inviting us. You know, So I wish everyone just stay safe.
Stay safe, everyone. If possible, try to get your first jab as soon as possible, like me saw here. Okay. I'm looking forward to the listing day. Have a good weekend, everyone. Bye bye.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.